All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Peter Jensen, the CEO of RocketFuel Payment Solutions. And Peter, welcome back. Nice to see you again.
Likewise. Thank you very much.
Yeah, so lots of stuff to talk about today. First off, let's talk about Bitcoin. And you know, it's at 67,000 today. It's been a bit volatile the last little while, but obviously hitting a pretty high note today.
Oh, yeah. It's going up. And it has been going up for a while. And yes, things go up and down. But those people who invested, I would say, a year ago or a month ago, they have made good money. And it's wonderful to see.
Yeah. Let's talk about a couple of things specifically with what you deal with. And that's the awareness. And I want to talk a bit about that, because I think that people hear negative stories sometimes about Bitcoin and crypto and all that kind of stuff. And really, that doesn't tell the whole story. And I think the awareness is something that I know you've talked about in the past that's really important.
Yes. As with all new technology, people need to feel comfortable with that new technology in order to adopt it. So what we need is we need awareness and we need adoption of all these digital currencies and assets. And that is, of course, dependent on A, the number of people being exposed, as well as whether they have a good experience. And the good experience has to come back to the reason they're using the digital currency. Some people use it as an investment vehicle. They invest in Bitcoin or something else, and they hope it goes up. And some of them, they just use it for practical purposes, which is the space that we're in, to move money from A to B, whether that's a corporation moving a lot of money to a different country or a private person paying for goods and services. So if the number of people exposed to the technology is going up and they have a good experience, it fosters the adoption of this new technology. And this is where, for example, the Bitcoin ETFs help a lot, because it's exposing Bitcoin in a safe and accepted environment. There are a lot of people who said, I don't want to create accounts with Coinbase and so on, but so I'm not going to go there. But when my advisor from Merrill Lynch or any of the other financial institutions are saying, well, you should allocate a small portion into, for example, digital currencies, it's a Bitcoin ETF, and who knows if there's going to be an Ether ETF later on, they're like, okay. They feel good about that. And the interesting thing is that group includes politicians and lobbyists and many other people. A lot of those people did not feel comfortable opening an account. Not that there was anything wrong with it, but they didn't want to be on the front page of anything, right? But now when they can do it through the ETFs, through the old-fashioned financial institutions, they are doing it. And so what we're seeing now is that we see a lot of these money flowing into Bitcoin. It's clearly why the price is going up, because more and more people invest in Bitcoin. And so a lot of people are like, well, where's Bitcoin going to go? Is it going to continue going up? And there are many reasons for it. There's the halving, many other reasons. But think about it. When politicians and lobbyists and people in the banks, Merrill Lynch, BlackRock, all the big ones, when they start putting money into it, my feeling is there's a pretty good chance that some of the laws that are going to come over the next year or so are going to be in favor of Bitcoin and crypto in general, as opposed to against it. If you're a politician and a lobbyist and you've put money into crypto already through an ETF, are you going to kill it with a new bill? I don't think so. And that is something that is very interesting.
Yeah. You mentioned about the ones like a Merrill Lynch or agencies like that of record that people know about, and people tend to listen to their financial advisors. And so how important is it for them to be really up to date on the world that's going on? I know most of the financial advisors do a lot of due diligence on things as well, but I would imagine that sometimes in the world that you're talking about, being super knowledgeable is really important in that type of event.
Of course, important. And all of these financial institutions, they've been around for a long time. They have tons of financial advisors. And when they bring new products to market, whether it's a new ETF within healthcare or what have you, they have a complete go-to-market strategy where they are training their financial advisors in a way so that they can advise their customers. So yes, it's important that that they are aware of it. But the good news is that these financial institutions, they have a framework of how to bring new products to market that includes training their advisors so that they can train the consumer, which is in our interest, because at the end of the day, our success is depending on how quickly we can spread this technology out to a lot of people that see the benefit. And so now we have an army of financial advisors touting the benefits of digital currencies to their clients that have had for tens of years. And these people, they are dabbling, they're taking their first steps into this, and they're like, huh, I had a good experience. Now I understand better what Bitcoin is or a stablecoin is, and I actually made some money on it. And that's what we need.
Yeah. You mentioned laws and what may come over the next year, year and a half. And I think a lot of people are interested in the halving event that's going to be coming up in April as well, because that's quite interesting. But as far as laws are concerned, I'm just wondering, will that help your particular industry, or will that at times hinder your industry? Or is that something I know you've been calling for some regulation, so to speak?
I do believe, I mean, I don't like a lot of laws, a lot of
red tape
and all of that. On the other hand, I don't like a free for all either. And the reason is, if we don't have some guardrails and some limits, it attracts the wrong people. It attracts the criminals and all of that. And that gives the whole industry a bad reputation. You have a few bad apples that ruin it for the rest of us. This technology has the potential to change our lives and make payments around the world cheaper, faster, safer. And it's a pity if a very small group can ruin it. And they have in the past, because there was not enough regulation. So it allowed some of the bad apples to do bad stuff. And by the way, it happens every time you have to do with money. It doesn't matter. I mean, the banks have been fighting anti-money laundering for the past, I don't know, 10, 20 years, right? And it still happens through their systems. And they have the same problem. Let me reduce the criminals' usage of my system so that the masses can benefit from it, right? So yes, we do need some rules and regulations. And by the way, a perfect example is the regulation that allowed the Bitcoin ETFs. It has helped our industry. Bitcoin is up. More people are getting exposed. More people are seeing the benefits.
Yeah, makes a lot of sense. Peter, thanks so much. Great to see you again. And we'll talk soon, okay?
Yes, thank you very much.
All right, Peter Jensen, the CEO of RocketFuel Payment Solutions.